My name is Nassime Saps.
Let me ask you a question. Has anything ever happened to you that you couldn't explain? That made you feel sort of foolish when you tried to tell somebody about it? Well, if it has, you have plenty of company, as you'll soon see.
I'm the hand of Mona Lisa's skirt. I'm a surprise, Captain. They don't see me coming. That's what you're missing.
There's so many brilliant things in the Bible, and you can read it over, and many people have done this, and they've led their life that way, but you can read it hundreds and hundreds of times. You know, David, they say great art, like the Mona Lisa. Some people, they look at it, and it doesn't look as great at the beginning, and then they'll look at it. By the time they see it many, many times, it becomes the most, they can't take their eyes off it. Mm-hmm. Whereas art that's not great, you look at it, it looks beautiful at the beginning, but you get tired of it. The Bible is special. The Bible, the more you see it, the more you read it, the more incredible it is, and the more you realize. It's like a great, you could say, I mean, I don't like to use this analogy, but like a great movie, a great, incredible movie.
I'm the hand of Mona Lisa's skirt. I'm a surprise, Kevin. They don't see me coming. That's what you're missing.
Let me tell you about my girlfriend. My girlfriend, Mona Lisa. She let somebody take a picture so she could be a fashionista. She said she wanna be a model, but why she wanna be a model? She told me that she wanna travel, walk the rumors in Milano. But I tell her that I love her, adore her, I need her, my Lisa. She told me trust her, I want to, I wanna trust her. And I don't know why it hurts me, hurts me, hurts me.
Why do I feel the hand of Mary Ann on this adventure?
Have you ever asked God for forgiveness? That's a tough question. I don't think in terms of, I'm a religious person. Shockingly, because people are so shocked when they find this out, I'm Protestant, I'm Presbyterian, and I go to church and I love God and I love my church. And Norman Vincent Peale, the great Norman Vincent Peale, was my pastor. The power of positive thinking. Everybody's heard of Norman Vincent Peale. He was so great. He would give a sermon you never wanted to leave. Sometimes we have sermons, and every once in a while we think about leaving a little early, right, even though we're Christian. Dr. Norman Vincent Peale, Frank, would give a sermon. I'm telling you, I still remember his sermons. It was unbelievable. And what he would do is he'd bring real-life situations, modern-day situations, into the sermon. And you could listen to him all day long. When you left the church, you were disappointed that it was over. He was the greatest guy. And then, you know, he passed away, but he was a great, he wrote The Power of Positive Thinking, which is a great book.
But have you ever asked God for forgiveness?
I'm not sure I have. I just go and try and do a better job from there. I don't think so. I think if I do something wrong, I think I just try and make it right. I don't bring God into that picture. I don't. Now, when I take, you know, when we go in church and when I drink my little wine, which is about the only wine I drink, and have my little cracker, I guess that's a form of asking for forgiveness. And I do that as often as possible because I feel cleansed.
Don't ever let him see you coming. That's the gaff, my friend. You got to keep yourself small, innocuous.
We interrupt your telecast with an emergency address from President Cecilia Harris of the United Global Alliance.
In a few minutes, the state will have justice over the rebel known as the Prophet. Let this stand as a warning to every man, woman, and child tempted to follow in his path. Diversity of thought will not be tolerated. His reign of terror ends today. Our truth is the only truth.
I'm not the one who's so far away when I feel the snake bite and tear my veins. Never did I wanna be here again, and I don't remember why I came.
Truth hidden in the light.